celebrities at Hello Kitchen. It's my first YouTube video in the kitchen for 2018. As you guys know, I went to Africa this past holiday season, and I've been posting a lot of videos about that, or I will be posting a lot of them, to the point that hopefully you don't get sick of them, but if you do, I'm sorry. What I'm really hoping is that you actually feel like you were there with me. That being said, this video, it's inspired by my Africa trip as well, but it's tasty. I promise it's tasty because let me just tell you, the food in Africa, seriously, what I'm about to make or recreate for you today is something I had in Africa that goes down in the books as one of the best things I've ever eaten in my entire life. You have no idea how many people were like, what are you gonna eat in Africa? Good luck with that. Sounds interesting. Giving me all that sort of lip. And I'm like, guys, I don't care. That's why I travel. I travel because I wanna see what kind of food is offered in other countries. I don't know why you guys travel, but I travel for the food specifically. When we were in Africa, we stayed at Kichiche camps. We stayed at two different ones, one in Mara North and one in Laikipia. Now, before we went on this excursion, we actually got sent emails asking us if we had any dietary preferences and all that sort of thing. You better believe I wrote down that I can't eat wheat, dairy, gluten, sugar, soy, fruit, and nuts. Yeah, I was like, oh, they're gonna have a hard time with this one because I literally have no clue what's, you know, available over in Kenya, but I gotta let them know because that's just my life. But guess what? They surprised the crap out of me. First of all, when I got to both camps, they told me that they watched my YouTube videos and read my blog trying to come up with inspiration for food to feed me, which was, oh my gosh, the biggest compliment ever. On top of that, the chefs are magicians. I swear to God, because the kitchens that they have are not exactly up to snuff. I mean, we were in the bush, so their kitchens were intense. Yeah, intense. I have so much respect for all the chefs in those kitchens. And let me just say, they created the most delicious things I've ever stuck in my mouth. Now let me get to the recipe I'm going to try and recreate today. Hopefully I do them justice because it was so good. On New Year's Eve, they served us a grass-fed beef fillet, so good by the way, and alongside came some sauteed vegetables and croquettes. Potato croquettes. For me, they made it Gigi approved, aka without all of the foods I can eat. So they made sweet potato croquettes and they were breaded in coconut flakes. Now, I'm not one to like coconut flakes. In fact, I've always thought they were absolutely repulsive. Like those Girl Scout cookies with the coconut flakes on it? Ew. But I wasn't gonna say no to the things that they created for me because I'm always willing to try something once. And yeah. Can I just say, I'm actually not embarrassed at all to tell you how many of them I ate because there was two that came on the plate and then they came back out to me because I had mentioned earlier in the day when I first got to the camp that I eat a lot and usually if I have dessert, it's another entree. So they came out and they were like, do you want more? And I was like, can I have the sweet potato croquette? Do you have any more? I really hope you guys have more because I want them all. They brought out four more, and I shoved them in my face, because this girl likes to make everybody proud. So yeah, that is what I'm gonna be making today. I'm gonna be making sweet potato croquettes, Gigi style, or I guess I should say Kichiche style, because Kichiche made this recipe. Let's get our hands dirty. I think I might be doing Kichiche proud right now because this recipe smells so amazing. Well, the croquettes are done and it smells freaking delicious in here. However, smells don't necessarily translate to how they taste. And I don't really know whether or not this is going to make Kachiche proud or not. I don't think I told you guys this before, but I've actually never made sweet potato croquettes or croquettes before in general. And actually, prior to eating them at Kachiche in Africa, I don't think I ever really thought about croquettes or even really knew what they were. And they come in so many varieties that I was like, eh, whatever, I don't really care. I just immediately sort of poo-pooed them because I figured I wouldn't be able to eat them. Kachiche proved me wrong. However, let's see if what I made is actually edible. I'm just gonna stick my hand right into the air fryer and try a little bit of this because I'm not sharing with anyone. If you guys have seen my YouTube channel before, you do know I don't really like to share my food. I like to share my recipes so you can make them, but when it comes to me making it, get your hands off my food. That being said, if this is freaking disgusting, well then it's all yours. This is delicious! I made something delicious! I really think if I served this to everyone in the kitchen at Kachiche, they would be extremely impressed and they'd want to know my recipe versus me wanting to know their recipe. I'm about to impersonate a lion on an impala right now. I'm stoked. I am beyond stoked, and I am so appreciative of the fact that Kachiche and my African safari inspired me to make this deliciousness. Oh, and by the way, this would be a really great recipe to make for those who like to snack during, say, football games. I do think there's a really big football game coming up this week. I don't know. Hey, you might be watching this in June or July and be like, what the hell are you talking about, football? But then again, if you're watching this in Africa, football is soccer, so you never know. There could be a big game of soccer right around the corner. This is a delicious snack to chow down on whenever you need something to grab on. Plus, the extra protein will help you feel satisfied for longer. Well, I have to go because my inner lion wants to chow down. Asante sana for watching this YouTube video. Asante sana, by the way, in Swahili means thank you. I do hope you subscribe to my YouTube channel, and I will see you next week.